Hey, you beautiful soul, hope you're doing fabulous today. Today, we are going to visit a very special place in my city, Toronto. It's the annual winter village in Distillery District. Distillery District is a very nice and romantic place where the buildings look like European buildings and the vibe is really artsy. There are so many art galleries, nice cafe, and sometimes there are some art shows and exhibitions, but every winter it turns into this really, really magical place. Last year, I went there for the first time, and beyond the pretty lights and Christmas tree and all the busy people, those buildings really caught my attention. Somehow, I felt like I need to know about these buildings. This place has a very interesting history, which I'd like to dig into. Shall we? In the 18th century, James Worts moved to Toronto from England. He had built a windmill which became a landmark for Toronto waterfront. The next year, his brother-in-law Gooderham joined him. Together, they had this business where they used to process grain from Ontario and then ship it via Port of Toronto. Within very short time, Worts' wife Elizabeth died during childbirth. Very depressed, Worts killed himself. Gooderham continued the business and he did very, very well. In 1837, with a surplus of wheat, he tried to produce beer and whiskey, and that business did extremely well. In the second half of 19th century, the farm rose to become one of Canada's most prominent businesses. By the end of 19th century, the company's growth began to slow due to various reasons. Eventually, it was sold to other companies, and by 1990, the manufacturing facility had been closed down. During this time, many commercials and movies were filmed here. Among them, the one that I care most about is X-Men. You know, the scene where Magneto finds out that he has some sort of power. So after a long, long time of being idle, it was decided that this place will be restored, where they tried to infuse Victorian industrial architecture and modern day boutiques, art galleries and restaurants. I went there just last week and it was a little bit different than last year, but still very, very worth it. So if you find time, you can go there. But before going there, please make sure you check the timing and other announcements. For this year, my only wish to Santa is I want to see him next year and the elves, and I want to eat the goodies and buy some mittens and whatever. I don't want to get used to with this new normal. This is not normal. With the good hope, let the merry time begin.